Jim, this is just wild to watch how many hurricanes and major storms we've had.
You know, that right there is not just tropical depression, but we remember what it was like 2 years ago when we just had a tropical wave give us all the rainfall in June. So it happens. Now they've got the rain to deal with, not so much the wind or anything else. Hard to believe that we're at the first day of fall when you see weather like that going on. But that's what happened at 8:31 this morning. We now are officially into supposedly the cooler air, and this total mind blow too. How about this? Halloween 37 days away. Yeah, look at those numbers right there. We're heading into the last part of the year. It's been flying by. Some clouds out there, but not very many. Plenty of sunshine to start off our afternoon, and those temperatures are warming up slowly. They're still mostly in the 80s. There's Tropical Depression Beta now, slowly, and I mean slowly, moving off towards the northeast, but at only 2 miles an hour, it's pretty much stationary. And that's going to be a problem. It's going to bring a lot more rain to southeast Texas. We'll look at that here in just a bit. Here's our forecast highs today. Near 90 degrees, some lower 90s inland, low to mid 80s along the coastal areas. West-northwest winds gusting up around 20 miles per hour, not too bad. And our normal valley average high for this day is 90 degrees. So we're looking pretty good out there right now. Out in the tropics, so we're going to take a look at the broad view first, the global shot here. And there's Paulette, again, still holding on with 40-mile-per-hour winds. Teddy is still a Category 2 hurricane as it has its eyes set on Nova Scotia now. That's a Category 2 storm, 105 miles per hour. And Beta, now a tropical depression. And the Hurricane Center is watching this area right here. Going to do a little loop-de-loop back towards Florida over the coming days, but only a 10% right now chance of becoming a tropical depression. So that's good. That will be a rainmaker, though, for South Florida. Again, here's the radar shot here with Tropical Depression Beta. 35-mile-an-hour winds, again, moving northeast at 2 miles an hour, roughly 15 miles east-northeast of Victoria. And it's going to take some time to make it all the way through southeast Texas. And here's some radar estimates of rainfall. Just to the southwest of Edna, there's one of the bullseyes, almost 11 inches of rain. But notice how sporadic it is. Some areas seeing a lot more than others. And then the next bullseye is right up in here, southwest and southeast Houston area, upwards to 16 inches of rain. And then a lot less as you go further northeast. But again, it's going to take some time for this to move away. So expect to see those rainfall totals start to pile up in other areas as well going into southwest Louisiana over the coming days. For us, though, sinking air, that's going to be our story. So a lot of sunshine out there, again, as Beta pulls away. There's our seven-day forecast. And looking pretty nice going through the next 7 days there. And yes, first day of fall. I know those temperatures are warm, but they're close to normal for this time of year. And we have had a little bit of a taste so far. Now the cold front approaches early next week, giving us our next shot at some rain.